snakes, wait for me, fakes, wait, I need breaks, wait, I need cake. How long can we wait? Come
you
on,
better not be the one to doubt us. Cause we've been putting in the mower. We only taking what was ours. So you better not be the one to doubt us. Cause we gon' blow your mind.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We're on to the divisional round now, two steps away from playing on the biggest stage in sports. It's the Seahawks going up against the Falcons. On the call here tonight, let's send it out to our guys in the booth. That's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Well, there's a new building set to open adjacent to us to the south, but for now, they're still playing football at the Georgia Dome, and that's where we're located here in downtown Atlanta. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Seattle Seahawks and the Atlanta Falcons. That's fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. To open things up, Malcolm Mitchell out of the University of Georgia was the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. All right, let's look at the offense. Devontae Freeman, this is a guy that you wanted to talk about, so take it away.
Brandon, have you seen a running back play with such joy as well as such fury? I love the way he runs the football and attacks defenses.
Second down now after the incompletion. For the first time with Devontae Freeman. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
Brad, wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Just a 25-yard punt. Not what he was hoping for by any stretch. Hawks in a great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. Now an Eastern Michigan man, Darius Jackson on the carry. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And some options here for the offense on second and two. They run again with Jackson. And some space here. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. A great effort there. 36 yards. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, Yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
That'll be taken in the end zone. Look at this. Middle of the field. A breakaway. Past the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. A great play there. 104 yards. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game.
Well, he made the right choice by result. But a little bit surprising because now with touchbacks coming back to the 25 instead of the 20, when guys fielded that deep in the end zone, I think most coaches want them to take a knee.
Yeah, it's resulted in more kneel downs. Not right there. Now that should give his guys a spark. He's up all the way to the 44-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. They go play action with Wilson. Deep drop. And he finds a man on the crossing route. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
And room there to work it inside the 25. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
We are watching a runner having a really nice game. Carrying it very well. Vision is excellent, but boy, look at the help he's getting. Offensive line, I think they're pretty eager to block for him.
Second and just one. They give to the fullback on the dive, and they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. All week in practice, they stress grounding, pounding the football, and they really executed it well there to get the first down.
That usually means getting back to being physical in practice, because when you emphasize pounding the football, it doesn't really come together unless you practice it the same way you're going to play it in the game. So that means more bodies, more pads, and a whole lot of popping last week, and they got it done in the game.
On the run, this is Jackson. And he's eating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Second down, 8. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. Go, 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 go So the chains are on their sides. It's first and goal from the six. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Now Wilson on second down. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver from 10 yards out. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. And he's able to put it through. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And a look at Seattle's defense.
When it comes to J.J. Watt, we're about out of superlatives, aren't we? So let's just make this simple. One of the best to ever play the game.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now a shotgun snap as he'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football? And the Seahawks add a couple of extra DBs going with the dime look here.
Indeed, six on the field. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Here come the Seahawks now set to take over on offense. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Now it's Jackson, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Okay, Charles, defensive starter time for the Atlanta Falcons.
And let's spotlight Keanu Neal, the safety out of Florida. So big, so athletic. Many thought they might make him an outside linebacker, but I think they're going to use him as a hybrid outside linebacker, strong safety, kind of in the Cam Chancellor mode in Seattle.
Here's Wilson. It's complete to Lockett. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. They come out here in the eye. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. The Seahawks send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. The Seahawks send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. This will be taken at the 10. A good return there, 17 yards. And it'll be Falcon football as they take possession. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Set up a throw, and he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Jackson, and he will score. Touchdown Seattle. A great effort there with his second touchdown here in this first half, and the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. That's fielded in the end zone. That's strong running. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Throw here on first down. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. They'll get 16 yards there. And that leads to an Atlanta first down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
They'll drop the throw. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean out of it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football.
Looking for Stills here, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
A gain of three, second down. Second down following the run.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They come up in an offset eye. On the ground, this is Jackson. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
For those who watch the game and want to question the courage of the guys who play on the corner, how about when you see a toss sweep coming your way, yet you still go into the backfield, get past the blockers, and make the tackle? That's big league.
They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And they'll go with a ground attack here as he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Offense in a good spot here, second and two. Second down, here's Wilson. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Two minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more NFC playoff action after this. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And they'll run it here. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Second down, Wilson. He's going to sling this deep downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did, take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Eighth play of the drive, forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. On third down, Wilson. And the third down pass falls incomplete.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
And this one is right down Broadway. And that will extend their lead even further. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And 2 picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw 4 or 5 picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. They'll look, and for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. So that is 3 interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but yeah, let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next year?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here, but he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind.
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. A great play there. Saving his best for the playoffs with his 3rd touchdown of the game. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And on 2nd and 10 now. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And he comes back with 1 complete. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Back to throw now on 1st down. And finding the tight end, Hooper. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. 6 yards here to go for the offense on second down.
Set, Green, 39.
Back to throw again. No, he doesn't have it. Maybe some alligator arms there going over the middle. Third down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Single, single, slot, slot. Hey, you're on an island.
And they insert their dime package, six DBs here on third and six.
Expecting pass all the way. They'll look to throw again. That's complete. Hooper. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. And they're going to speed things up here.
And fix the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
And here comes play number six on this drive. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Back to throw now on second and 10. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. Now play number seven of the drive as they're looking at a third and 10.
Here we go now.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. Here's Matt Bosher now as he's on to punt for Atlanta. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Out of bounds and close. The question, was it a touchback? No. They'll say it crossed out at the 2-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
And now a carry here for their fullback. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act. And hello, I guess Larry's halftime show is buttoned through. And we are moving on and ready to go for the third quarter. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Time to the tailback, and he'll get this one across the 20, but only up to about the 21. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
So third and seven, and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A really good pickup of 28 yards. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. And they'll go on the ground. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Four yards remaining now on second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Five yards to gain here on third down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. From the gun on third down, Wilson. He's going to float this, and this is caught. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. A big play there. 44 yards. And the Seahawks are running away with this one. And he'll bang that one through. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half, other teams just...
And Freeman lost the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So they almost turn it over there. Scary moment, second down here. They'll set up to throw. It's complete to Fuller. And they'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down. And a pretty simple completion there underneath, but a successful one for the offense.
Partner, doesn't have to be the big shots downfield all the time. Having that safety net underneath is a great thing for a quarterback.
On third down, Devontae Freeman. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one, you know the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
They'll look to throw here on first down. He finds Malcolm Mitchell here. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. They're going to hurry back to the line now. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Here we go now.
He'll look to throw. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
As the field starts to get condensed, the defense likes that a lot because now you don't have as much space to cover, but a well-run corner route there.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Back to throw again. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Their big tight end from 10 yards out. And the Falcons get a bit closer. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Well, how many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he stopped immediately there. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game, and while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. Defense thinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. On 3rd down, Wilson is going to float this one deep right side. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Their dangerous wide receiver. His 2nd touchdown of the night. And the Seahawks offense continues to pour it on. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. And here now come the Falcons. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. They come up in an offset eye. After the penalty, here's Freeman. Evades the tackler and now some space. That one good for 14 yards. And that'll make this a second down.
That was a good, strong run there. While one picked up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
Freeman again. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. One receiver left, two to the right.
Green, 39! Green, 39! Gone!
They'll look to throw now on first down. It's caught, Mitchell. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar.
And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And now he'll tuck it and run. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. A lost opportunity.
And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And ready for 3rd and 6. They come up in an offset eye. Going to give this time to the tailback. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
The Seahawks send out their punter. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And finding the tight end, Hooper. That throw good for four. It's second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Back to throw here. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Third down is the down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And it is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. And a great spot to start this drive from here. They come out here in the eye. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit. Even though I'm not rooting for either team, that was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. And on the ground they go with a running back. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave them with a third and 11.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Will the defense dial up the pressure? Let's see. Third and 11. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there. Not a whole lot of real estate, but a nice carry.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
For the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This a 33-yard attempt. And Sturgis able to knock it through. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
That'll be taken in the end zone. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No,
either.
You don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They come out here in the eye. On second down, Freeman. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.